There are only 9 more sleeps until Batman v Superman Dawn of Justice hits theaters. And for today's featured story, we've got the movie's prop master to give us an up-close and personal look at some of the Batman's coolest gadgets.
Batarang's one of the more iconic things in Batman's world. And Zach wanted to make this more of a presence in the movie, like a calling card and something that really could stand out. I had a few illustrators working for me and we came up with multiple designs, but this was the one that ultimately Zach chose, and he liked it because it had many different cutting edges, and he wanted it to really be able to stick in anything anywhere. You know, it's that there was a more lethal aspect to it.
And let's move on to Batman's grappling gun, all right? What went into thinking about the design of this?
Well, you know, we were thinking, first of all, what is the practical aspect of a grappling gun? You need to have a spool of cable, some winding device, a way to cut cable and to reload, essentially. And one of the modifications that Zach had us do was to create this little return on his handle so that he could use the gun actually as a hammer. You know, when he's in a fight, he could fire, but he could actually, you know, use it around and do whatever he needed to do.
That's a great design, man. Now let's talk about the thing that's been looking me down this entire interview, the tech cowl.
You know, Alfred spends time in his workshop in the Batcave.
Okay.
And part of the reason to make this was really to give him something to do and also to fulfill one aspect of the script was to deal with his voice generator.
I thought she was with you.
So if you think about this being against your throat, this little piece would actually transmit. It'd be close to his vocal cords. He could communicate with Alfred back at base, you know, that sort of thing with it. Clearly, his vision goes through some multi-powered phases, and we have illustrated that by putting in a series of retractable lenses. They're meant to come down and really suck right into the cowl. Certainly visual protection, but also enhances his sight and gives him heads-up display. The undercowling is almost like a helmet for a jet fighter pilot as well. You know, it incorporates a bunch of technology. We had so much fun making stuff, and Zach is such a huge part of the design process. I have to say, it's just a lovely experience being able to work with Zach and make stuff and collaborate with him for the movie. He's a real visionary.